In this video, I will be showing you the BIM.com's design app for Revit. We will use it to find high-quality Revit families made by actual building component manufacturers. But this is only a small part of it. The app also helps you make informed, data-driven design decisions early in the process. I will show you how with just a click of a button you can get a full building LCA, or life cycle assessment, of your Revit model to understand the environmental impact of your design choices. Let's go! There are many LCA tools out there, but most of them, if not all, take a very long time until you have enough data connected to get a real insight into what your design looks like from a sustainability point of view. With the design app, we want to make this easy. You should be able to spend most of your time on your model rather than be looking up for EDP values to use. To check out BIM.com's design app and to follow along with this video for free, check out the link up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. Now, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are inside of Revit. Now, before we actually start working in Revit, I just want to show you the website. So this is the BIM.com website. This is where you can learn all about the BIM.com's design app. So as you can see, we can reveal our carbon impact of our design. This is exactly what we want to do. So I'm just going to download it. Well, you should download it. I already did. So I'm going to get started and feel free to go download it completely for free. And then you can follow along. So once we're here in Revit, I have already downloaded and installed the design app. So what that means is when I navigate to the add-ins, here we have the BIM.com design app, and I can just click on launch, which is going to launch it. It's going to open up as a separate window, just like this. I don't have any projects, so let's connect our Revit project. And now, before we actually connect it, I'm just going to minimize this for a second, and then I just want to show you how I'm going to prepare this 3D view. So I have created a whole new 3D view, so it's called 3dbim.com, and here I just want to make some adjustments because we don't want to run this carbon calculation for the entire model. We only want to run it for the things that are actually going to be built and the things that should be included in this calculation. So for example, all of the furniture, all of the things like that, I have removed from the model. I have just hidden it for this view. Also, for example, for the terrain, we don't need to run a carbon impact for all of this earth. So I'm just going to hide this in view as well. And now we're left with only the parts that we want to use for this calculation. So this is the 3D view, and now we can go back to the design app, and now let's connect our Revit model. Now, of course, if you have multiple projects, you can simply create a new one. I'm just going to click here on connect your Revit model, and this is going to start a new project, and let's name it. I'm just going to name this the test project. We should also define the size of this project. So in this case, this will be 1100 square meters, and then let's click on create. Now, the next step is going to be to actually connect the model. So we have created the project. Now let's connect the model. And for that, we need to specify the 3D view. As I've mentioned, I have prepared this special 3dbim.com view. So I'm just going to select that one and then sync it up. And as you can see, it's now calculating everything and it's syncing up the project, and boom, we get some confetti, and these are the results. So this is what we have as kind of the results from this view. Now, what's going on here? Well, what we can see here is that we have our project emissions, and basically what's going on here is that elements are being matched to carbon data. So the design app is taking all of our elements, it's dividing it into categories. So we have the walls, the floors, the structural framing, and so on and so forth. And then it's using the carbon data sources. In this case, it's just using the generic carbon data source, the ISO 1467, and it's basically matching the information or data from here with all of the individual categories, and it's then producing our project emissions here. So currently it's at 400 kilograms of CO2 emissions per square meter. Now, what we can do here is we can open up individual types. So in this case, we have opened up walls. Also, I can go back and I can simply see here, okay, the red one is the largest one. What's that? If I click, that's the walls. And this is what we have for those walls. So matching here is being done again from the generic carbon data. It's looking at these walls. It's looking at, are these structural walls? Are these non-structural walls? Are these exterior or interior walls? And it's also looking at the materials. So what are all of the materials? And then it's trying to match up with what's closest within the generic carbon data. And in this case, we can see the standard. This is a very popular industry standard. And now for each of these, we can click on them and then we can see all of the individual instances. So this is on level 2, we have this floor, we can see so the level, we have the carbon emissions, we have the carbon impact, and then we have the quantity. So we can go to each one of those, and then as you can see, it's breaking all of this down to all of the materials that are included, and then we can see what product is being matched to what. So you can get a clear picture of what the design app is looking at when it comes to calculating all of these results. So here we have all of those instances. For example, if we go back to Revit types, now we can see, okay, so here we have the floors, open up the floors, and then we have all of the information for that. We can go into instances, explore that, so on and so forth. So I'm just going to go back here to our project emissions. So now what I can do is I can set a budget. So for example, I can say 450 kilograms of CO2 emissions per square meter is something that I have set up as my budget. And then if I go here to sync history, as you can see, we're at 400 and we have a little bit more left. So we have about 11% of the budget left and we have used up 89%. And here we have the results. Also, if I go back here, we can see that down here, we have that sync history visible. And also for these carbon data sources, by default, it's going to be using the generic carbon data. And you can see the exact standard that's being used, but it's also going to pull from individual manufacturers if you're using some of the elements in the model that have manufacturer data, so that can be matched and then you can have an even more accurate assessment or calculation of the carbon emissions. But now let's actually test how we can make changes in the model and see the results when it comes to these carbon emissions. So the walls here are obviously making the largest impact. So let's investigate that further. We're going to open up those walls and then here we can see all of the types. Now the strongest impact is being done definitely by this exterior wall. So this is something where we can explore how can we reduce some of that carbon emissions impact. So I'm just going to minimize this and then let me select that exterior wall. So it's this wall here. I'm going to go into edit type, open up the structure, and here we can see what the structure is. And then I can say here, so for the main structural layer, let's say I want to change that. So let's search for some concrete. I'm going to use this, for example, the cast and suit concrete, click OK, OK, apply, and then let's see if this makes a change. So let's open up the design app back again. I'm going to go back here to the full model, and then let's resync the model. Let's pick the view, this is the one, and then let's resync this data. And here, as we can see, we do have a very significant change that we can see here, obviously. So this change has been really beneficial to our model and I'm quite happy with these results. I can go to the sync history and as you can see, we have gone way down from where we were previously. So that's really, really good. So we can obviously monitor the changes that we make. We go here to resync model. You don't have to remember where you were. You will get that here in the sync history, which is really powerful. Now let's explore another part of the design app, which is the Discover tab, or the Discover button. And here in this environment, we can pick and choose different models. So different Revit families that you can use. For example, I can open this up and then I can search for some BIM objects. I'm actually looking for a very specific door, so I'm going to search for that. So I've entered the manufacturer. Now let's say I want this to be just swinging doors, and then yeah, we can pick out from one of these, for example. I'm going to search for something a bit smaller. Let's see what we have here. So I found one that they like, so I'm just going to select that. And as you can see here, we have the Revit model, which we can then download and load into our model. So I'm just going to click here to load into Revit. And now, as you can see, this family has been loaded in. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to hit the escape key a couple of times, select one of these doors that we have in the model, right click, and then go to select all instances in this particular view. And then I'm just going to change this here to this particular door. There we go. And now if I click away, this is what we have. As you can see, this is that door. Now here it has this active display of the clearance zone, which then I can just turn off for one of them, or I can actually, again, select all of the instances in this view, and then I'm going to just turn that off for all of them, and then this is what that's going to look like. So it's really powerful and really easy to load in these families. Also, what you can do here is you can add them to your library, meaning that once this is added to your library, when you go down here to libraries, well, you can see that this is where all of my families that they have saved from here are. And you can also load in your own families here. So this can be your kind of library for working in Revit and then easily loading in elements, so you don't have to go through different file menus and so on. It can be all saved here, and then you can load it into the project easily. So there we go. That's going to be my review of the BIM.com's design app. It's really powerful, and I really love the just the possibilities when it comes to this analyzing the carbon emissions impact, and also the fact that we can sync it up and then make some live changes and see how that affects our carbon impact, so we can make some informed design decisions. As I said, the link is going to be up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. It's completely free, so feel free to test it out for yourself. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.